Hi, it's Amy and Tim from Go With Less, and today's video is all about travel hacking, and more specifically, house sitting, and why house sitting is what we think the ultimate travel hack. Okay. We hope that you'll stay tuned.
We are currently on the adventure of a lifetime. We are on a 9-week European vacation that we pretty much put together using the points and miles that we hacked together. And we've currently, even before we left the United States, we had spent about $8,500 worth of points and miles to put this trip together. We would not have been able to afford this trip in any way, shape, or form if it weren't for those points and miles. So this trip would have been way out of our price range. And so we're going to talk briefly about what travel hacking means in a traditional sense, and then we're going to focus on how house sitting, we believe, is the ultimate travel hack. So in a traditional sense, travel hacking means that you're signing up for credit cards and you're earning airfare miles or hotel points in order to stay for free at hotels or to be on flights for free. And so Amy and I have a special model where I spend a ton of time, I call it a hobby, spending many hours a week actually on this hobby.
I think it's more like a part-time job.
There you go. Earning points and miles. And then Amy spends time picking out the routes that are going to be the cheapest. So she spends them. I earn the miles, Amy spends the miles. And both of those things are critically important if you're going to be doing travel hacking. So you wouldn't want to earn a whole bunch of points and then flush them down the toilet doing something that's crazy or let them expire. So together we spend a ton of time focused on this travel hacking thing in a traditional sense. However, we believe we found the ultimate travel hack with house sitting. We have had amazing experiences with house sitting. So this is like the ultimate accommodations hacks. We're currently in France at an incredible house that has an incredible kitchen where we can cook.
It's incredible.
It's incredible. It's amazing. All the superlatives, you name them, this is it. So we also were here for Bastille Day, which was amazing. We were here for the World Cup where France won. That was amazing. Last summer,
we were in Santa Barbara and we were at the beach with a dog for 10 days. We brought our daughter for that one.
We've sat in a 10,000 square foot house in the foothills of Colorado. That was a crazy experience.
That was in a home that had a movie theater and a second huge kitchen. And then this past Christmas time, we were in San Diego with two cats, totally chilling at the beach at Christmas time. We've been in the mountains of Breckenridge, which was amazing. So we've had some really great experiences. We find we like to cook at home, and we found many of the houses that we've been fortunate enough to book have great kitchens.
And if you're trying to quantify the value of these sits in terms of accommodations, I would say at any place where we've traveled to be at a sit, these places are easily in the hundreds of dollars a night. If you were paying to be in this place, you'd be paying multiple hundreds of dollars a night to be there, whether you're in this house or someplace else. These are great locations. And
we pick great locations. We're not picking awful locations. That's
exactly
why we're going. So yeah, so we're going to talk more about house sitting here in the video. Tim and I like to say that the cheaper we can travel, the more often we can travel. Travel is by far our biggest discretionary item in our annual budget. So we are crazy careful about maximizing every dollar we're spending, and we're kind of hyper focused on that because, again, we're looking to travel as often as can be, and we don't want our budget slowing us down. So when we talk about budget travel, we could travel so much cheaper than we do. We could sleep on a park bench. We could couch surf. We think couch surfing is wonderful. That concept isn't for us at the moment. We like privacy. So there are ways to get your travel cheaper, and we get it and we've looked at it, and it hasn't been something that has worked for us. So we're looking for some kind of a private accommodation. And here's where house sitting comes in. We are members of the largest house sitting website in the world. I'm going to put a link down below which has a referral code which gives a discount, and it extends our membership by a couple months. And it's called trustedhousesitters.com. What's really cool about this is that there are maybe 1,000. There are so many house sits all over the world, and almost there's pockets where they're much more popular, but it kind of is in almost any corner of the world, which is way cool. And you pay some sort of a nominal annual fee, like somewhere about $125-$150 for the year, and after that there's no money exchange. So you're not getting paid to do this. The homeowners aren't paying for us to come to their home, paying for our airfare or anything like that. But the idea is we are staying in somebody's home and taking care of their entire life while they are gone. And there's no money exchanged after everyone gets on the website. Now on the website, we are heavily vetted. We have a background, both of us have a background check. We have reviews like crazy. Tim and I, in order to get those reviews, we did maybe 10 sits, house sits, locally at home so that we could go meet the couple or the family, secure the sit in person so they could meet us in person, and accrue sits so that when really competitive, amazing sits came on the site with 50 plus applicants, we looked great because we have all these references and we're already kind of checked out and vetted. So with our early retirement, we were able to go and do those house sits, which was a really great strategy.
The local sits.
Yeah, the local sits. And so now when the big phenomenal sits come about, we look really great because of that homework that we had done. So we're going to talk about what house sitting is and what house sitting isn't right now.
So the first thing we want to say about house sitting is not a vacation.
Hold on. House sitting is not a typical vacation.
That's exactly right. So on the first phase of our trip here in Europe, we were traveling all over the place. We were going from hotel to hotel. We were out 12 hours
Airbnbs.
A day seeing the sights, and Airbnb seeing the sights. So we could come and go at our will. And oftentimes we leave in the morning and we weren't back till midnight. That cannot happen at the vast, vast majority of house sits that you would be at. So you have to be home to take care of the pets. You have to be home to take care of the house. You're basically running the household as if you were the homeowner. And so the pets typically have a routine, and you need to be here to make sure that the pets are taken care of as your number one priority.
Yeah, so maintaining the pet's routine is kind of first and foremost. And we just mentioned pets a lot. It seems everyone we've ever had, every house sit, has had pets. And while a couple don't, the majority, like the vast majority, do have pets.
So saying that, I would say that Amy would say the same thing. So we'd both say this, that loving pets is probably going to be high on the list also of things that you're going to want to have on your radar if you're interested in.
If you hate pets,
house sitting,
you should not be considering
that's
this.
Exactly right. No.
Yes. The majority are cats and dogs, but people have all kinds of pets. They have horses and chickens and pigs and snakes and lizards. That doesn't mean that we take care of all of these things. And there are some people who are allergic to cats and they don't
take
care of cats.
There's some people who only sit cats.
That's exactly right. So the gamut is out there. But if you are a pet sitter and you're taking care of pets, I like to say, Tim isn't as big into this, that we are their fairy godparents. I like that, I think, more than Tim does. But we're their fairy godparents. We are giving them so much love. And where the owners are often out to work or doing their life, we're probably home more than the homeowner is. Like, almost all the time we're home more often. And so we are loving up on the pets. Like, the owners come home and are like, holy cow, my pets had, like, so much love and attention. Like, I really wasn't expecting that so much. But they've been spoiled rotten. And so it's kind of the opposite of a kennel where they might be locked in.
I prefer to say that it's like where they're grandparents, not fairy godparents.
Whatever. It works for me.
Tim
just lets it go. But yeah, so loving pets would be a great one also.
Something else that's going to serve you well in the context of house sitting is being a prior homeowner or having some experience just as being a handy person. So if you've ever owned a home, you've probably dealt with situations where I have an issue with plumbing, so I've got to call a plumber. I have an issue with the electricity, I've got to call the electrician. Or I simply deal with these
things. With the pets.
That's exactly right. Or I just deal with these things on my own. So the more resourceful you are, the more handy you are, the better that's going to look on your resume, I think, to homeowners. And
it will make you feel more comfortable on a sit.
That's exactly right. So there's the world of possibilities. And so when you go into a house sit, the more you know about a given, how to deal with scenarios in a given house or a given situation, the better off it's going to be for you and the better off it's going to be for the mindset or the
comfort.
The comfort of a homeowner.
Okay. Yeah, and I'm going to talk about communication. So both communication beforehand as well as on a sit. So beforehand, we do maybe a little bit of emailing through the site that I mentioned, and we'll also get to a Skype call or a FaceTime call, something in person. So we can connect live on video. They can maybe tour us around their home with an iPad or a phone or something like that. We can meet the pets, see how the pets do, take a peek at the home, understand if like the vibe between homeowner and house sitter meshes and gels nicely, understand like expectations and just see if it's a fit. And then on the sit, it's important to stay in touch with whatever fits for the homeowner. We've had homeowners who left and have been totally incommunicado the entire sit. So once they left, we never heard from them again, and they didn't even return like a text, the one text that we sent. So that's happening that you might need to be totally on your own. Another thing that might happen is a homeowner might want you to send a daily picture of their pet. That's also normal. So meeting that expectation for communication is also key. So if you just want to tune out completely, that might not be the best situation as well. So this is something you're going to be maybe sending updates at the very least every couple of days about a house and a pet, and you will just follow the homeowner's lead on that.
Yep, and I think communication before and during the set are equally important.
Flexibility is a huge part of house sitting. The homeowner generally has dates planned for their vacation, their business trip, their event, that they're going to be away from home. Tim and I don't have the most flexibility because he still has a daughter who's in high school and we are kind of with her calendar.
However, that being said, we haven't had an issue finding dates that line up or sits that we want. So I guess two things have to line. You have to find something you want and you have to be available. And so we haven't had an issue, I should say Amy, because she does all the legwork here, hasn't had a problem finding amazing sits that line up when we happen to be wanting to be traveling.
Yeah.
But flexibility is going to give you a world of options that you may not otherwise have. And so the more flexible you are, the more options you're going to have available.
And I will say, like, I don't say I want to be in this place on these dates. That would go off the table completely.
Yep.
To say I'm looking to go somewhere in a warm climate roughly these dates, that might be accommodated if it's an area that is kind of hot for house sitting. So when Tim says, it's not like I say I want to go to New York from July 1st through the 13th, and we're going to find that. That's not going to happen. Like, that's not going to happen.
No.
I also want to talk about who is house sitting right for. I think it's good for singles, couples, families. I've seen many ads that say they have a skittish pet that only does well with solo females.
Oh, you meant singles. There you go. You're about to say that. Sorry.
Yeah. But solo, single, solo. Some people want families. They have kids and maybe they want to share this experience with another family. So just because you might not be exactly what you're thinking is the ideal sitter, that doesn't matter. There's all kinds of homeowners that are happy to take you. Also, if you have your own pets, number one, you can bring in a house sitter to take care of your pets. Also, some pet sits allow you to bring your own pet. They're fewer and further between, but they're out there.
We've also heard that like a new homeowner may be interested in having a new house sitter because they're both new to the game, and so there's something to be said for, it seems like there's a spot for everybody who wants to
sit. Yeah, and it's individual. So there's not like one way of doing this in any way. It's very individual. Now, I do want to talk about profiles. So it's key in your profile to sell yourself. So it's not just I've always wanted to go on a vacation to this area, and I'm excited about this area. I want to go on vacation to this area. I want to explore this area. I've always dreamed of going to this area. What's in it for the homeowner? So what would be better is I work from home. I'm writing my book. I'm working to create a website.
Something that's going to keep
something
you at home.
That maybe will keep you at home. Something that's in it for them. Like why? So they don't care that you want to come in. Explore their area, to be honest. That's not in it for them, but I love to give a lot of love and attention to your pets.
Yeah, the idea here is you're selling yourself in the eyes of the homeowner. So
like, why would the homeowner want you in their home?
That's exactly
when other people are totally like killing it and have a lot of experience, why would they want you in their home? So do keep that in mind. Fill in every single blank if you do get on a website. Fill in every blank. Fill in every photo if you get an opportunity to upload a video. Do that. The house that we're on now, I ask every single person in a competitive sit why they picked us. And I love the answers, actually. And it helps me understand what are people resonating with. Well, the one here said, even though they had many, 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 many applicants, that it was our video that really sealed it because they felt connected to us. And it's just like a one-minute little intro video.
Just like a resume for a job or a profile for a dating site or something, you want to put your very best foot forward. And you want to think about the messaging that the homeowner would want to hear, not what you're interested in. So you don't want to say, I want to be the best house sitter in the world. It's what am I going to bring to you as a homeowner that's going to set me apart from other people that may be coming into my home. Again, so, like Amy said, if you're going to be here doing something that's going to keep you at home, there's a lot of value in that.
If you're not a smoker, make sure you say that.
If you're clean, very clean,
very responsible, all of it. So we are going to wrap it up. We're going to be talking more about house sitting. If you like this, please give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe. Please comment below. We reply to everything. And if you think that other people might benefit from learning more about house sitting, please share this video. We would so appreciate it. Please stay tuned for another video tomorrow.